speakers.
Where'd you get
yeah,
that at?
Yeah. From powerbag.com.
Oh, that's
my sponsor, John. He I guess he works with them.
That's what's up.
So no, yeah,
no, you
yeah,
have to get all the good perks.
Yeah, so I guess Joey, you want the power?
Oh shit.
He doesn't have an accent, but it was, he's Japanese and white.
Japanese and white. Yeah.
So he's like freaking Brandon Lee and Bruce Lee, right? So
yeah, he's both. How do you guys intro the show? Is it music?
You'll see.
Yeah? Yeah.
I'm excited. Yeah. Don't be all excited.
Ooh,
I get wet.
That's
easy.
How we get into it.
Did you just say what I just thought you said? Get wet?
Sour wet.
Oh, dude.
Is there a camera to see the back of my hair? I just want to get stopped.
Yeah.
All right. Which is my go-to camera?
See that girl? Right, you see that girl sprawled wide open?
Right here.
Look over there.
I'm trying to be Christian tonight.
I like your posture. It's real, like... Real.
Well, more relaxed.
Mine?
Yes. Looks like you're...
Chilling.
Real chilling.
Yeah. Like I got an imaginary girlfriend.
Let's check out the other cameras.
Well, you from
ooh,
one?
There you go. Stallion is almost in full uniform.
Stallion, man?
He's in the timeout booth.
How come I can't see Stallion?
I'm in the booth.
You can see him right there.
Well, how do I see him?
He's look on the TV right there.
Yeah, see?
See?
Oh! I was like, man, that's cold. He invited us and he didn't come. He's hiding.
Oh yeah, we got about 1 minute. We're gonna kick this
already?
Show off.
Sheesh.
Yeah. Hyped up, everyone. Hype. Hyped up.
All right, you want a soul clap?
Soul clap.
Come on.
Can I get a soul clap? I feel like I'm in trouble. Sit here only. Sit here only.
I didn't say that, did I?
Yep.
You're just implying that.
Built a grind in the house. B2G in the place to be.
B2G.
Joey, are you nervous? If you get hot, you could take off your Bruce Lee tracksuit.
I know, man. That's old school. Right there.
If we spar naked, blood.
Hey, did you get that merry-go-round?
Nah, blood. It's chess king.
That's when he was working at Glamour Shot.
Chess king.
Did you just say, oh my goodness.
Who worked at Glamour Shots?
I did, twice.
Yeah, he got fired.
No, they began to rehire me. They said, you know what? They had me taking pictures when the photographer was there. I had no idea. I had these kids posing and like weird. You see the pictures all messed up.
That's crazy. That is nuts.
Instead of cheese, I'm like, can you say peekaboo? What are you stand there the whole time?
Oh, no. I'm sitting down.
Oh, okay.
Alright, I think we're almost ready to make this happen, guys.
Yeah.
It is that moment. It's going to go silent for 1 sec, but
actually,
it will rise up here on the Slam Show. Everyone, stay tuned. Yep.
We need a mirror in the studio.
I know.
Xenon, the Virtual Entertainment Programming Network. TVEPN.com.
Welcome everyone to the Slam Show for April 23rd, 2012. I'm the Commander-in-Chief of this little shindig we call the Slam Show. As I always do, before we go into anything, I'd like to introduce my co-hosting staff. The lovely person that's sitting on the stool is...
Whoop-hoo,
Lady Sage. Big round of applause.
Woo! I already have the giggles over here because of this guy.
I thought it was him laughing.
In the sound booth, we have my incomparable, sometimes impossible to deal with by love and the death, DJ Stallion.
Oh my gosh, I love Jack Tripper.
And our special guest host, coming in straight from V-Town, it is the recording artist that has an incredible music video on CMC right now. Let's give a big round of applause for the Catch Me on Balling, DL DeArson.
Built to grind in the building.
Exactly, built to grind. I'm repping 100% as well as Stallion and everyone else, except for our incredible special guest, which he has his own little flavor.
LL Cool J 87 suit on.
Anyways, this is about to be a fun show. Watch this.
Anyways, let's give a big round of applause for mix host and comedian Joey Gila.
Joey!
It's so good to be in this garage.
Welcome, Anak.
Thank you guys for having me, man.
What up, nice. Man?
Brother, it's good to be. You got air conditioning?
Exactly.
Seriously, I feel good, man. Dude. I got thin black dress socks right now. It feels like good.
Well, I'm glad that you were able to make it down from San Leandro.
Yes, don't say that too loud.
Stop it.
I was going to say, like a nicer area. You said San Leandro.
Oh, man.
Yeah, no, I live right by Bayfair Mall where the weaves are made.
Oh. All about the weaves, huh?
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Hey, man, it's all good. It's all good. Anyway, before we get into any type of discussion, I want to go ahead and play a track that Mr. Arson was able to put together for us specifically here on the Slam Show. It's actually his version of the Slam Show theme song.
And do it live?
Nah.
So this is DLD Arson putting together It's the Slam Show. That's the title of it. You guys enjoy. Let's see if Mr. Gila has a few moves for this. Shake it.
All right. Don't look serious.
It's the Slam Show. It's the Slam Show.
I'm feeling this.
It's the Slam Show. Where it's at Monday nights for Dan Show.
DVEPN.com.
Built to grind. DL to Arson. It's the Slam Show. They get it cracking. It's the Slam Show. Where we be laughing. It's the Slam Show. There's no acting. It's the real thing, man. Let's rock. The Slam Show every Monday night is where it's popping. Special guests, different topics. ATM, they be rocking. TVEPN.com is where it's at. Hear some jokes, have a laugh from questions that is asked. Slam and Sam plays the jams to get you bouncing. Beware, cause DJ Stallion will get the clowning. Better have some humor, they'll surprise you, man. Especially if you're not a Niner fan. There's no show like him with their crazy ways. Shout out to the lovely lady Sage. She holds it down for the women. It's obvious they be winning. From Monday night shows to Redux when they spinning. No bull, no bull, like Nitro Liquid. They so cool. I advise you visit their website, their page. Bet you won't complain. They the only thing to look forward to on a Monday, huh? It's the Slam Show. It's the Slam Show. It's the Slam Show. Where's that Monday night for Damn Show?
Ooh, that was a...
Oh, man, let's give a big round of applause.
Damn. Right on.
That was slapping.
That was dope.
Right on. That was
my new wedding song right there.
doing that clap part at the end, I can see these two sisters is clapping the booty.
Oh, you can see them twerking, that's for sure. Hey.
That's going to be the clapping part at the end.
Dude, that was hot, brother. Right. Seriously, on, man. One more time. Big round of applause, man. I like that.
Oh, thank you.
That was dope. That was dope. I like that.
Yeah, DL came through big time on that track. And also, as we always do on each intro, we talk about our weekend happenings. And let's go ahead and go into that real quick. As far as Thursday, what did we end up doing, Sage?
Well, TVEPN The Slam Show supported our sponsor, which is Liquid Nitro. They had an event at Studio 8.
Mm-hmm.
And, man, Bobby Brackens was there. Allie Davis.
Yes, yeah.
And she's hot. And, that was a good event.
I'm going to go ahead and throw up a slideshow of a little occurrence. Yep, that is magnetic tape on their freaking,
with Twisted Candy bikinis and Bay Mando.
That's right. We also had always our crew members hanging out, BTMEA, and it was just a phenomenal time. Stallion was doing this thing over at Redux, hanging out with Rich Era, making it happen there.
He was hanging out with me.
Exactly.
Yeah, it was cool. You know, we threw it down, did the whole thing, and then you guys were on the other side of the bay.
But you were there in spirit, Stallion. Don't worry.
Exactly. That's all that counts. So we fast forward to Saturday's happenings, and this is where DL's significant other came through and helped out Sage's photo shoot for her up-and-coming super site. Yes, not a regular website, but a super site.
It's not a Bustos website either. Super site.
So these are little clips of her photo shoot. As you can tell, it was very well done. Yes. Go ahead and give out the props to everyone that was
props
involved.
Props out to my makeup artist, Donna Margo, and of course the photographer, which is Jonathan Remote, going as Remote Control with his assistant, April.
That's right.
And my other assistant, Slam, who wiped off my sweat throughout the day.
Hey, I had to do something instead of just like waiting and...
Bastos.
Yeah, yes. And bastosing myself.
Yeah. What is bastos? Oh my God, what is it? Something aborigine language.
Oh, I'm sure you know about that. And later on that evening, that's when it all went down, right, DL?
Yeah.
Come on, man, be engaged. Be engaged. This is the part where everyone from Built to Grind was able to come out and have a good time. As you can tell, we are well represented on this show.
Yes.
We also have Built to Grind members, Junior and Orville, chilling in the audience.
In the building. Yes, I see them. You don't see them.
Yeah.
Was the camera seeing them? They're squatting. One squatting.
They came five deep. I thought it was a Jabba Walkies. Jabba mask.
But yeah, can I say a shout out to Charm? It was her birthday. She brought a whole entourage. It was awesome. It was an awesome event.
Exactly.
And of course DJ Jason, he's not here tonight, but yeah, shout out to you.
Yeah, let's go ahead and run a quick slideshow of the event. Yeah, we're going in little details. Look at that. Packed house. As always, Redux, they get the big props. Gina, Mike Q, Enrique, all you guys, you make it happen, allowing us the Slam Show to rock it.
That's not City Nights remodeled?
Nah, man, that's the other side.
That's what Fresca said last week. We're going to go hang out a
there you
night.
Go. So there's some little action there.
Oh, shit.
You like that?
Ooh.
Yeah.
Slow motion, hip hop array?
Hip hop array.
Damn, dude, your head's shiny.
Brilliant. That ain't his head.
That's Mr. Professor X Bustos.
The mic.
Oh, shoot.
Yeah, see, so we're in action. Orville's like really having an orgasm at that point.
Orgasm.
But right on, so.
Throatgasm from all that alcohol.
Enough of what we did.
Hey, before I came there, dude, I had to do a wedding up in Livermore.
Damn. Yeah, how about you had like some real issues with that, right?
Yeah, I mean, it was cool, though, but, you know, the bride wanted to move me, like, 10 different spots and couldn't make her mind up.
What the hell?
Yeah,
she better give you, like, a grand for every movement for doing that crap.
I know, man. I'm like, dude, seriously, outside, inside.
Yeah, you guys are telling me the show's going to be like this.
Bro,
this is really perfect.
Yeah.
I like that. Let's go.
So I met.
Dude, she wasn't Filipino, was she?
No. You guys would have been there if she was.
We're not Filipino, though.
Oh, yeah?
I'm going to India.
I'm Asian alien.
Oh, yeah.
But overall, it was a good time, right?
It was cool. You know, and then I got out and I mashed the Redux.
Yeah.
Got the front spot, you know, VIP like always.
Just like Built to Grind getting over here in like freaking 15 minutes and shit, huh?
Yeah, that's
all behind the wheel.
Orv was mashing.
Well, at least you guys got a carpool and shit. Joey came over there, a little Mini Cooper. He weaving in out of traffic.
Yeah, dude, you're really going to find... your stalkers are really going to find you.
I didn't say it was a pink one.
You painted it, boo.
Where you live.
Got to fly a rims out there.
Yeah. Sorry, I like the pink one. I'll pick everyone up in the Mini Cooper.
Mr. Rocket Thuggin. So what'd you do this weekend? Yes, you. On camera.
For me?
No.
Oh! I heard like 18 voices. It's going to be go bam now. What did I do this weekend? Actually, I did some thug stuff. Costco. You know? Costco.
To get some Hennessy.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Get some more gel and hairspray?
No.
Dude, what?
Costco is Costco. Oh my God. Let's talk about it.
Go for it.
Yeah, the employees, I love them, but you know what? They don't train them. to like, you know, to help the customers. You know what I'm saying?
They just give you a box. Here you go.
Yeah. I'm asking them if they need help. I'm like, yeah, you guys, you know. But no one, I just wanted a rotisserie chicken. That's all I wanted.
Oh, shit. That's the bomb. I mean, it's the biggest freaking chicken that they sell. Yes.
It's huge. Yes. My wing had hair in it, but I still ate it. I'm like, man. No, but that's the thing, though, man. You know, on my weekends, like when I'm not performing, I just do like Costco, Target, right, Walmart. Right. You know,
so that's like your freaking stuff. Your happiness is going to those places, right?
Yeah, everything by the belt. Condoms are bigger. It's baggy,
right next to the baby section, huh?
How about Best Buy? Do you go there and like escape as well?
Yeah, I love Best Buy.
Really?
Yeah.
The one here in Pittsburgh freaking shut down, bro.
Did it? What?
The Costco did?
You guys be robbing it too much. That's bad. The Berg,
you can't buy bullets in bulk at fucking Costco.
The Berg though lasts. I love the Berg. Someone tried to carjack me off a railroad back in the day.
Are you serious?
Yeah, seriously.
Dude, I told you be very truthful before we came on the show.
Yeah, it was off a railroad, man. I had, check this out. I thought I was cool back in the days.
Uh-huh.
I had a Nissan Sentra with a Phantom top with some little Daytons. Right?
What?
I think it's the ugliest thing now, but I thought I was cool. So, yeah. Right off the railroad, they tried to carjack me.
No way.
Yeah, I didn't even cry loud. I cried inside.
So how'd you get out of it?
No, actually, he knocked on my window with a pistol.
Yeah.
Right? And he goes, "Spare!" No, I'm just kidding.
Dude, it was gonna blow up.
Damn.
He had an accent. Hey, my name's on it. That's cool, man. Can you put doctor? Doctor?
I'll do it on the break, for sure. Yeah.
Dr. Feel.
Who's circumcised? Raise your hands. Everyone circumcised?
Yeah.
Jesus.
Hey, man, there's a lot of... Hey.
If I was a circumcision doctor, my shop would be called Cut It Up. Would that be good?
Yeah. Oh,
hey, man. Cut you up.
I like that.
Cut it up.
Well.
Well, DL, what did you do this weekend?
Man, I was...
Besides the Redux.
Oh, Redux. And then yesterday, we had a... I wasn't that eventful, but we had a B2G meeting. Actually, it was. Our B2G meetings be crazy. But, you know, rocked out with John and went to the meeting hungover.
Damn.
Meeting was like at 12:30. We woke up like at 11.
Yeah.
Hurt, too. But it was cool.
Because you guys freaking mashed it over at Redux. And all I got to say is thank you very much for making it out, exploding on it. Too bad Junior wasn't able to make it, but he'll make it on the next one. That's for damn sure.
We had some dandies and people were passing out on the table and shit.
Yeah.
We missed it.
No, that was. Oh, shout out, Jen.
I didn't say any names.
That was you.
I didn't say no names.
Shirley.
That's right. Cool. So we had an incredible weekend, guys, and it's just phenomenal that we're all here tonight to go over some incredible discussion. I can't wait to get this ball rolling right now.
Mm. Yeah, and I started my nitro shit yesterday.
Oh yeah, you got the nitro lean program.
Yeah,
thing.
I did.
All right,
I started it. Lean. Motherfucking shit got me up at 7 a.m. today.
What?
That actually works. I mean, I haven't been eating junk food, and it works.
All right, there you go. Shout out to Joe, the entire Liquid Nitro party posse off the hook. Is making it happen.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to go ahead and take a quick commercial break and be back with the sports segment here on the Slam Show. Hang tight.
Here we go.
Graphic design. Marketing and advertising. Visit us at www.baymanda.com or give us a call at 650-571-5100. Baymanda offers 5,000 UV-coated club flyers starting at just $99.99. Place your orders today for rock-bottom prices at baymanda.com.
And now you know who's best.
If your child is not breathing, roll them onto their back. Check airway is not blocked. Gently tilt head back, hold nose and breathe twice into mouth, place heel of hand in center of chest, and push down 15 times. Repeat breathing and chest massage until help arrives. If your child is...
You know how to help your child if they've stopped breathing, but do you know how to help them if they have a drug problem? Visit drugfree.org for information, help, and advice. This message brought to you by the partnership at drugfree.org.
Quality never goes out of style. And the quality of the Paul Frederick White Pinpoint Oxford dress shirt at just $19.95 will make it the staple of your wardrobe. This special introductory offer won't last forever, so act now to get the quality, comfort, and style you can only get from the Paul Frederick White Pinpoint Oxford dress shirt. Order today and receive free monogramming, a $9.75 value. Go to 1995shirt.com and enter promo code COLLAR. That's 1995shirt.com, promo code COLLAR.
This season, take tailgating to the next level with Mr. and Mrs. T Mixers. Hand off some Bloody Mary mix in original, bold, and spicy, and premium blend varieties. Delivering true made-from-scratch taste with game day convenience. Mr. and Mrs. T Mixers promise perfect cocktails, even if the season isn't.
Goodyear presents awkward conversations between guys in cars.
So you admit you have tire amnesia?
Yes, I have tire amnesia. Aha. I do not remember what brand of tire I happen to have on my own car.
Yeah, it's like you don't care.
Dude, I
do. Now, see, thing is, experts, people who really put their tires to the test, like NASCAR, they don't have tire amnesia.
But I'm not an expert.
Because NASCAR prefers Goodyear tires.
I'm not an expert.
Oh, and the first tires on the moon? Goodyears, chosen by NASA, heard of NASA?
Yes, will it make you happy if we pull over and see what kind of tires I have?
You don't have to. These Chevy Volts all come with Goodyear Fuel Max tires. They can help you save gas.
Wow, I have Goodyears?
Oh, so now you care.
Yes, I care. I care.
Goodyear, more driven. Receive up to $160 off with mail-in rebate when you buy four select Goodyear tires with your Goodyear credit card. Goodyear credit card purchases subject to credit approval. Certain conditions and restrictions apply. See retailer for complete details. Goodyear official tire of NASCAR. NASCAR is a registered trademark of the National Association for Stock Car Auto Racing Incorporated.
I tweeted all that stuff about that guy in the moment, you know? I never thought it'd be right there when you Googled him. I mean, it makes him look like, you know? Well, I actually became a customer of his before he closed. Oh, man, the internet. You gotta stay on top of that thing.
On the internet, everyone is entitled to their opinion. Even this guy. That's why there's Reputation.com. Reputation.com understands that negative material about you online, no matter how untrue, can impact your reputation and your business. And you may never know the extent of the damage. Reputation.com helps you control how you look when people search you, managing reviews of your business, and pushing down misleading and malicious search results. Act now and get a free reputation assessment conducted by our expert advisors. Call us now at 800-283-1144. That's 800-283-1144. Or go to reputation.com.
Welcome back to the Slam Show. This is a sports segment sponsored by Liquid Nitro. All energy,
no bull.
And BayManda.com for all your graphic needs. Printing on all that, BayManda.com. All right, guys, to kick off the sports segment, obviously, all of us are Niner fans and so forth, and we hope that the team really does well this season. The draft is coming up and so forth, and you're always going to have the two top picks that everyone knows is like the prime guys no matter what. And this particular year, we know who's going number one and number two. It's two quarterbacks, Andrew Luck and Robert Griffin III, RG3. Now, these two guys are self-proclaimed the saviors for the franchises that are going to be the Colts and the Redskins. My question to you is, which one of these two guys are going to be the better quarterback this coming season and in the future? Sage, go ahead and start off.
Well, there's always been a hype with this Andrew Luck. Of course, he's going to the Colts. I mean, that's why the Colts purposely lost throughout the whole season.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So they can get this guy. Fuckers. Now, the Robert Griffin guy, so what, he's like the next Michael Vick?
Yeah.
Slash Cam Newton, so he has that DNA like meshed together, and boom, there's Robert.
Yeah, exactly. So who's your choice? Who do you think is going to be the better quarterback? Because there's no way it's not going to be him not being chosen. He will go to the Redskins. Andrew Luck is going to the Colts.
I'm
going to
go with Luck.
You're going to go with Luck?
Only because it's Luck. There's no rhyme or reason to it, just because of his last name.
Hey, you never know. Stallion, who do you think is going to be the better quarterback?
I think it's
going to
be Luck too, but you know, I don't think the Colts deserve him.
Oh, because of all them tanking all the games?
Fuck that, man. They don't get shit. You know what? It should be like the runner-up of the Super Bowl because they're the best. Right?
Just really like
stacked. And because they lost, they get the better quarterback now. But fuck that, you know? And Luck's probably going, fuck, really?
Yeah.
Really, well, I have to go to the Colts? They should have a choice. He should be like, I don't want to.
There's a method to their madness, so.
We know.
We'll see what happens.
Exactly.
I think personally it will be Andrew Luck. I'm not too keen on running quarterbacks lasting really long in their entire career because obviously injuries play a big part. So I know Robert Griffin III is super talented. He's probably going to be great on freaking Madden. I can't wait for Madden 13 in that case. And so let's talk about the real deal. I think it's going to be Andrew Luck. Anyone else want to chime in? Joey? Dio?
whoever the black guy is, that's what I pick. So, but I know nothing about sports, man. I'll be honest with you, man. When you guys talk about sports, I just kick back and listen. But
oh, you like to soak it in, like when the Sage starts going into it, like, oh my god.
Hey, that's real though. What Joey said, that's real. I mean, you know, when you're not. I mean, honestly, me, I haven't even watched TV. I don't watch TV. I don't even know what my
couch. Because you're in the lab, like, dude. You're in the lab making hits.
I'm on the go, but no, I mean, as far as, like, sports, you know, to keep it real and just be like, I really don't watch sports because, you know, shoot, me myself, too, like, so, I mean, honestly, I just started getting into it, but, you know, there's some people that, you know, they'll just jump into a conversation. Like, you're talking about basketball. These motherfuckers talking about soccer. You know what I mean? So, right. You know, that's real.
But you are a football fan, right?
Yeah, no, definitely. I mean, like I said, probably within the last year and a half. But I don't know sports like I know, like, hip-hop. That's my sports.
I feel that.
So I know Costco. Third aisle, tires. No, I'm just kidding. No.
That's funny. And closing out this topic in terms of what the Niners are going to pick, Sage, what's the main need? Because obviously they almost made it to the Super Bowl. That was incredible this past season. What can they get out of the draft that's going to be suffice and going to make them take the next level?
Any wide receiver.
Really?
Yes. You know why? Crabtree didn't do really shit the whole season.
Yeah.
So, pick up a wide receiver. I mean, honestly, I mean, what? Smith?
Yeah.
I don't like him. But you know what? I'm going to go for a wide receiver.
Okay. Stein, what kind of needs do they have? They need right now the San Francisco 49ers.
No fumbles.
Obviously.
Yeah, that was the one that fucked him up right there.
That's true.
No, he's talking about players.
So there's no players that are going to be significant? Hold on to the ball, right?
Yeah, just hold on. I mean, they picked up some good weapons. You know, they'll probably utilize them. The coach is really good, but, you know, the dream would have been getting luck. Fucking boot. Alex over to the fucking Colts. Right?
I love it. I love Stallion's, like, really candid insights.
So, you know, he's not a Colts fan and a Raiders fan.
Yeah.
Noted.
Yeah, the Colts, they don't deserve shit.
They
should be one of the teams that fucking they take away.
I don't know. We'll just see how it plays out with the whole draft, and if anything, it's going to play out to where Jim Harbaugh is going to pick the right player, and we're just going to go ahead and move forward. It's going to be a successful season regardless.
What about Nerf football? That's my thing right
there. You're funny. You must have said Nerf football. All right, check this out. Moving on to the next topic. This gentleman right here, Antonio Cromartie. Wow. Check this out. He is the Jets cornerback. He is expecting twins. Now, check this out. Adding on the twins, that'll make it 12 kids for Cromartie. 4 with his current wife and 8 with 7 different women.
Baby mama.
This is Maury.
He need to change his playbook. That's what he needs to do. Fuck
out. Are we watching Maury right now?
Dude, think about that. Just kind of wrap your mind around that whole situation. This guy is an elite football player, but yet he cannot freaking control his sperm at all
at
any point.
You need to take him to Costco and get some condoms.
Think about that.
Maybe that's his age, though.
That's what it is.
Every time he has a kid, he wins a fucking...
Eight different freaking...
Baby mamas?
Yeah, 7 different women.
And he better stay in the game, though, because, man, if not, that's a lot of child support.
That's what I
mean. He is already.
He has a helmet on the wrong head.
Play football until he's 50.
Yeah, for real.
And that's what freaking dead in football years.
Nope. I agree.
So. Be sponsored by Itchy Cream pretty soon.
You're playing good luck to you, sir.
See, the thing is that when he was traded to the Jets, he actually had to get an advance from the Jets in order to get things going because he was so behind on child support.
He needs to get a vasectomy. The Jets organization should have taken him straight to the doctor and said, you know what, you're getting your thing cut off and tied.
And tied? I gotta cut it off and tie it. The fuck? Tie it after you fucking cut it off and throw it away.
Man, that would hurt.
I'm just saying. Because
basically, basically
and tie it.
And you could freaking get anyone pregnant by looking at them, that sort of thing. That's how
all
potent
the cheerleaders
he is.
Are
belly button. Be safe.
All the cheerleaders are all big pregnant girls.
I don't know. That's just a really...
Hey, he's making his own team. Leave him alone.
Exactly. What do you think about that, Mr. Gila? The whole... just
I don't know.
Everywhere.
I don't know what his pickup line is. That's what's trippy, man.
I believe
what
football.
What is his pickup line?
I don't know.
I mean, what
I'm attracted to
athletes was what I want
to
know.
I'm not attracted to athletes, but they're just attracted to his supposedly the money he's going to be bringing in. But all actuality, he, you know... They only get paid when they play the games. They don't get, like, an advance of, like, whatever, what, $130 million they're supposed to get paid. You know what I mean?
That's a pickup. That's a pickup line. His bank statement.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's what it is.
So he's just carrying that like on his like his Bank of America app. He'll just say, "Look, this is all the money I got right here."
He wears his helmet everywhere on the wrong head.
But yeah, that's too much.
I don't know. But
much. I think because it feels so good. Damn, it feels good. What? That's why there's children, because it feels good, man.
Just keep it real on.
Bro. Man, that's...
I hope she gets like a C-section. She probably got a zipper there.
Doesn't he know how to pull out?
Obviously not.
I know.
Seriously.
Someone need to teach him to pull out.
Because wrap your mind around this. Each kid from the average is going to be close to $500,000. So you start doing the math. That's how what you're going to provide. And that's going to be connecting for the rest of your life, whether it's going to be from the baby's mama or things related, you're just connected.
Right.
So,
I mean, when this kid calls, he doesn't know which one it is. But like, daddy, who's
oh,
this?
Oh, check this out.
Yeah, then he plays.
Daddy, check this out.
Daddy!
She knows my states. Florida.
To kind of add on to it, there was a film crew production team that wanted to do something to cover Cromartie and talk about his whole situation, and he was like, hell no, because my baby's mamas are gonna start taking all the freaking funds from that show.
That's a reality show right there.
Yeah.
To me it would have been okay if it's just, you know, one baby mama, but several, that's drama.
It's crazy.
How many different baby mamas you said?
Seven.
And think about this. He was getting interviewed, and they asked him point blank, can you name all your kids? And he was like pausing.
No.
He got a name.
I'd be so hurt.
Like I said,
three.
He has fucking
number three.
Number
that
that
is
number
nuts.
Six.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
That's
why it feels too good. That's what it is.
All right, closing out the sports segment. We got one more discussion on football. It's actually the video game. We are down to two players for the Madden cover. Yes, we are talking about Madden.
It's not Tebow.
Wow. Aww. It is between Cam Newton and Calvin Johnson, a.k.a. Megatron.
Woohoo!
Now, Cam Newton, he went and made a YouTube video proclaiming that he deserves to be on the Madden cover and that he's the best player, and he doesn't believe in curses because obviously we know that there is actually a real Madden curse. If you're on the cover, you're going to get fucked up during that season, either through injury or being non-productive. He has a lot of balls saved for saying that. Straight up.
Now, I curse you.
Let me ask you this. Who should be on the cover? Megatron or Cam Newton?
I'd go for Megatron.
Really?
Cam Newton, he's just a baby. Plus, what? Just because he racked up all those fantasy points, you know, you're justified to get on the cover? I don't think so.
Well said. Well said. Stallion, who should be on the cover? I know what he's going to say. Something way off base.
Luck. So the Colts will lose again, and they'll get the new quarterback for next year.
He's just incredible, isn't he? That's why we love Stallion. Just gives the freaking X Factor answers on everything.
Stallion's dope, man. I like Stallion.
Yeah.
Who's that, Charles Barkley?
I think personally, it's going to be Cam Newton, as much as I don't want it to be, because he'll probably be like one of the top fantasy picks when people play.
I honestly would pick him, though. Just, yeah, on the real talking shit, but exactly. I will pick him. He'll be my number one quarterback.
DL? You want to chime on something? Because you were pointing.
No. No. Oh, no. It's good.
He was pointing to the camera.
Oh. No, but actually, you know what? Since I heard X Factor, man, nobody really knows, but I actually tried out for X Factor.
Yeah, talk about that.
This weekend.
And I made it to the second round.
Oh, and then what?
No, but I didn't make it past that.
Oh,
yeah, at least you got a second round.
Yeah, no, it was all good. I mean, man, there was like, she goes second round. He was like, are you a rapper? I'm like, yeah. He goes, is that all you do? I'm like, all I do. You don't sing at all? I don't sing at all. He's just, all right, go ahead. And then he was just like, I don't think today. But there was some chick in front of me that she had Mariah Carey like dead on, and they cut her.
She was big too?
No, actually she wasn't. She was actually pretty blonde hair. She actually looked like kind of like Beyonce, kind of, you know, resemblance to that.
I don't know her name, but Vanessa.
Oh, that's DeAndre. DeAndre.
Was her name Vanessa?
Oh, yeah, there was drag queens in there and, you know, just all type of weird characters. But, hey, man, shout out to everybody that's at the next round. And, man, wish y'all luck.
We're going to see you on TV?
No, I don't think so. On CMC.
Hey, That's for
sure. That's the only TV.
That's for sure, man. And congratulations for that.
Right on. Yes. Thank you.
Definitely, definitely. All right, we're going to go ahead and close out the sports segment. We're going to take a quick music break and be back with the entertainment discussion. Hang tight here on The Slam Show.
Gonna pop me. Bring it back.
That's a little HP Gang. She ready. It sounds like he's saying freaking DL in it, right? You hear that? It's like a little DL.
Yes, I hear that.
I didn't, but hey, it's dope, though.
Welcome back, everyone, to The Slam Show. This is the entertainment segment sponsored by Perfect Tan and Natural Light Foods. Check out their banners as we do the placements in between the breaks.
Can I do a quick shout-out? Speaking of Perfect Tan, they also gave me a Mystic cocktail for my photo shoot.
Ooh.
And Kimmy Ann, my the girl who colored my hair, she's awesome. I love my hair. I'm blonde.
Yeah, you. I like it. That's
See?
Nice.
Yep.
That's. I used to be blonde.
So shout out Kimmy. Moi.
Right on, right on. That's the way to do it. Gotta give the plugs for all their hard work that they were able to come through for you, Sage. That's for.
I love
damn
the.
Sure.
I love the hookups.
Oh yeah.
All right. First topic on the segment. Check this out, guys. We all know who Suge Knight is. Well, he's actually
a Samoan dude.
Yeah. Yeah. You know what? He does look a lot
that
Samoan.
That dude is Samoan.
He motherfucker.
He basically went out to the limb and said that Tupac, after this whole hologram special thing, is that he's still alive and that he faked his death and believes he's somewhere just kicking back, having a good old time. And apparently he was the one that gave like $3 million to have Tupac cremated. And the guy that he gave the money to just flat out disappeared, never found, never seen him ever since. So let me ask you this, guys. Is Tupac alive?
Yep.
Yes.
He lives in Pittsburgh.
He lives in that closet when Stallion's not there.
In a scraper.
Yeah.
See, I've
been saying that shit since 96.
You know what?
All fucking Suge Knight's fault.
It is.
Car got shut up, and then Tupac ran away and hid.
and they're hiding them out.
That is the weirdest thing. Keep in mind, Suge Knight was in that vehicle. DL,
yep.
Since you're looking at me direct, because it seems like you want to chime on this, since you're the rap connoisseur, what do you think?
Honestly, I don't think Tupac is alive. I mean, everybody in the world knows him. If someone really spotted him, I mean, you see all these fake, you know, so-called, you know, Tupac sightings, but, you know, I mean, how I look at it, of course, I mean, his music's always going to be alive.
Mm-hmm.
Him, he's gone. Shit, right. Somewhere. But I know this, his hologram is giving way better performances than half of these rappers, you know, out there.
That's amazing.
I mean, you know, it was, no, I mean, you know, seriously though, that show was dope. I heard it cost like over like 100 racks just to do that. Yeah. And now they're even trying to do like Biggie ones and, you know, but
how about a Tevin Campbell one? That'd be great.
He's not
dead. Oh, yeah. But his career is.
I love Tevin.
He just come out
with some transvestite.
I'm just kidding, Tev.
You busted out. Give it Tevin Campbell.
Not dead, right?
No.
You know, I was telling Stallion earlier that there's a whole bunch of possibilities that we'll never, ever find out, because once you reach a certain level of success to that degree, and Tupac, he wasn't always the most liked guy or someone that really could go anywhere higher. He could only go down. Who knows? Anything's possible. You know, anything's possible.
If I was Tupac, though, you probably think, where would I hide? Daly City. Hello, Filipinos look like Tupac. At ceremony, everyone looked like Tupac.
Really?
Serious? All bald. Everyone
with the
you look like Tupac. Take off your hat, blood.
Y'all the same.
Show him.
Dude, I haven't even shaved it yet. It's Saturday at Redux.
That's a skinny rock right there. I like that,
though. Oh.
Cover light. That is cover light.
You're the second guy that said that.
Good looking brother right there.
Nice. Good. That's mine.
That's your, you guys want to make out on the show? Can we see that?
Come on. No, that's it's going to be X-ray.
In the booth.
It's
going to
be X-ray.
My fucking Italian.
An Italian?
He's Italian and Filipino.
That's a Pinoy right Fuckers. There. He knows more about Filipino music than I do. He's playing some Filipino love songs where he beats her together. This guy got pretty eyes, too. That's why he's wearing sunglasses. Come on, bro. Stick your head out. Let me see you.
Look on the monitor.
There he is. Oh, brother. Yeah, why are you wearing shades in that hat?
So I can look around, man.
Come on. I'm going to take you my Mini Cooper right now.
So I'm texting you, girls. You can't see me.
Oh, I love you guys. This is a great
I hope you brought some food from Goldilocks when you came.
Hell yeah. See, you know, it's a trip growing up with Caucasian brothers like him that know more about Filipino stuff than sometimes we do.
Mm-hmm.
That's dope.
You could be mixed with one.
Yeah.
Caucasian.
There you go. There you go.
He's like, I'm Italian, fuckers.
Yeah.
He's like, there's a difference. There's Jersey Shore and there's me.
Vietnamese's.
I'm not that Belgian.
In your fuzz.
I'm a little bit.
Moving on, guys.
Get some pop food out of here.
Check this out. The next topic, researchers.
We're talking about Tupac. He's alive.
Researchers at Texas University have designed a chip that can make, check this out, smartphones the ability to see through walls, clothes, and other objects.
See through clothes?
Yes. I don't know if it's to this extent like we're seeing the video from Smallville where Superman actually looks through. And,
Smallville.
Wow. Think about this, guys. My question is it going to be kind of like that X-ray mode as when you're going through the terminal in an airport, or is it going to be truly like we're seeing right now where it's clear as hell, you're going to see some bustosness?
It's going to be an accurate pube count. That's what I see.
Yeah.
I honestly think it's like scanning your baggage and such. It's not going to be as clear as Superman's X-ray vision.
Really? So it's just going to be like a regular X-ray thing.
It's like, what's that? Is that cocaine?
No, so think about this.
It's just pills. I'm just saying.
Let's think about this.
I'm just going to try it one time right now.
Because you know at the airport, you know, they see stuff and like, we still got to open your bag, ma'am. We see something in there. And I'm like, oh, God, go ahead.
Well, think about this. Once you have that smartphone being able to do this whole X-ray thing, it just opens up a whole bunch of doors of just crime abilities to happen. Whether it's just trying to find out what's in a safe, finding out who's at home. Who knows, man? What's your guys' thoughts?
That's crazy.
I got the app already. 99 cents.
I mean, there is no privacy after someone sees what you have below the waist. You know what I'm saying? Because a girl could just be on a date and be like,
"Oh, that's a deal breaker."
I know. Yeah, a guy could be too. But, oh shit.
Yeah.
See some curtains.
Instead of guy.
Yeah, you like, scam the girl, man.
It's not as tight, but used to be.
Yeah, but some big ass lips look like Jay-Z.
So okay, wait. They're seriously. Talking about they're talking about through clothes.
Yeah.
Meaning that you could see body parts. That's what I'm kind of baffled about.
That's the thing
about.
That's we don't know yet, because this technology is going to happen. It's just a matter of when and what type of applications will be used effectively with that. So think about it. Anyone wants to chime
what's
in?
The purpose of it?
It's just to see things.
Just to see things.
Yeah, see through things.
And this is available to the public.
Yes.
With the app.
Wow.
I think the government should use it for airport terminals, so they don't have to like scan like this or pat you. I think it's just should be used in businesses.
Okay.
But not in for private. I mean, public uses. It's just way too
powerful.
Yes.
Hmm. All right. That's so it's just like having someone with a nuclear bomb. It could go really bad, really fast. An X-ray smartphone.
I know some nasty Filipino invent a backpack GPS. That's what I that is so bad.
I was born one. No shit.
You'd be like, backpack 2 blocks away. This backpack 2 blocks away. Make a left at the backpack.
Oh my goodness.
You guys were back there, but you guys were always late.
This is a bad show. You say you can say anything.
Yeah, you haven't even cussed yet, right?
Oh, no, I haven't said bad words.
Oh, wow. You're just being the good Christian guy that you are, right?
He said peck-peck, though.
That's an adjective.
It's hey, we want some.
Yeah.
That's what it means.
Ooh, you got it there, Sage. All right, moving on to the final topic here on the entertainment segment. Yes, ABDC is back. Season 7 is on. And I'm still a big fan. I know things are kind of watered down because they were... For some reason, they were able to bring back Fanny Pack from the previous seasons. They're cool with me.
Yeah, obviously, because you took a picture with them.
Oh, yeah.
Get them on a show.
They actually were at a showcase that I DJed. There you go. There's me with the little hair.
A little. That's hair.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, see? Fanny Pack is in the house. And basically, we checked out the preliminary... routines and so forth, and Sage and I have come to a conclusion. We know who we think we're gonna pick as winners.
Yes.
Or as the main one. Who's seen it yet? Joey?
Yeah, I've seen it. I don't know a lot of the new names yet. Like, I watched the first season. I mean, the show. The first. You're talking about the season now, right?
The season now, yeah.
Oh, right.
You
not the one with the Jabberwockies.
You know, the little kids are actually pretty good, man.
Yeah.
Those little kids. Oh, half of them are from Hawaii,
those
right?
are mixed elements.
That's right.
Four are from Hawaii and four are from L.A.
That's right.
And what's fascinating about them is that, you know, four, of course, practices over in Hawaii and then in L.A. But when they performed, they just so mixed well together.
Yeah, and they actually use the webcam like we're doing now to sync up.
Yeah.
I saw that.
So it's pretty good.
How about those other little kids, the art of technique? They should have got them on there.
Which
those little kids. I think you posted a video of them.
Yeah, yeah.
And those kids are bad.
Yeah, they're local. Man, you know how it is. You've been to those auditions. They're really, really tough to break.
So they did audition?
I believe so.
Okay.
I think they should have separate kids and then, you know, adults.
You think so?
Yeah.
Well, I think they have it to where it's all mixed up because it is a very tough competition to get quality acts.
Yeah, because they don't have a lot of experience because they're just, you know, they're babies.
Right.
Have
just like
double
you.
The year. Yeah. Thanks, but I owe you.
Actually, there is a group that they have to, like, not participate in high school or be in high school because they're dedicating their time and stuff to do these dances.
Yeah. What group is that?
And that is...
Rated Next Generation, right?
The Seamen. That's how young they are.
Yes, that's right. They're Rated Next Generation.
Yeah.
They're from Seattle.
Yep. So, do you have a pick, Sage? Which one is going to take it all right now?
Most Wanted Crew.
Most Wanted Crew?
Yes.
Yeah, they were pretty good. Mm-hmm. Most Wanted Crew is actually a whole bunch of choreographers.
They're a group of choreographers who gives back to the community.
Oh. Yeah.
And that's what I really like about them. All about charity work, philanthropy,
such. Yep. You know what my pick is? Fanny pack. Yeah, I'm going to show that picture again just because I took a picture with him.
They're dope.
I fanny think they're going to go ahead and win it all this time.
Dude, why are you dressed like Mario Lopez?
Because I was trying to be like him at the event of the showcase.
Is that a flight jacket?
That's my Top Gun jacket.
That's what I'm asking.
Leave me alone.
It's on the patch on the side.
So, Stallion, did you get a chance to look at it?
Yeah, the Filipino guys are going to win.
I think they got eliminated. That was the mixed elements.
Yeah.
Oh, they got eliminated?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, they're not going to win then.
Well, I think who's the one that was with the...
Lil Mama's going to win, Lil Mama.
What was that group with the Filipino guy wearing the skirt that had the whole gimmicks?
Oh, Step Boys.
Step Boys.
Yeah, they were kind of like...
The weird ones?
Yeah, they were kind of like too cheesy. Like their comedian, their act is based on comedy and... I don't know, a little bit of nudity, perhaps.
Yeah.
It's a little everything.
Yeah, a little everything.
Yeah.
It's something you would see on the Filipino channel.
Exactly.
Yeah. Showtime. which I hear every day in my house.
So, based on what Stallion said, that's his pick.
And you know what? They're from Roseville.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's here, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, Mr. Gila, do you have a choice?
You know, honestly, I don't even know their names, but I'm going to watch it next week for sure. Or this week, actually.
Well, you can describe it to me, and I'll tell you.
Yeah.
The ones that dance fast.
No, you can go ahead and pull a stallion and say it was the Filipino group.
Yeah, the Filipino. I know. There was it? There's always like one Filipino.
Yes, like the black guy.
Yeah, it's a black guy.
That guy would win.
Who would think Filipinos would be on this show? That's a trip.
Yeah,
why don't we see more and more Asians on TV
everywhere
dancing?
Well, you're on TV.
Kinda a little bit for a smidget.
Oh man, we're gonna get into that obviously when we go into our next segment. But excellent, guys, being able to give your insights on it. But yeah, I think
what do I win if my group gets chosen?
A sticker.
It's a grind sticker.
Yeah, there you go. And the little whatchamacallit backpack thing with the string.
B2G Josh.
You get a fanny pack. You get a fanny pack.
Nice.
That's an I win, Stanley.
Sam, you get Sam's fanny pack from 92.
Oh, man.
Get all his tapes in there.
You're pulling the freaking...
Can you play my tape? Zip. I have a fanny pack.
Hey, you're not only dating me, you're dating Joey Gila. So, there you go.
He's your uncle.
We got a whole hand.
All right, that closes out the entertainment segment. We're going to take a quick
break.
How are you the uncle, but younger?
Check this out. This track we're going to play right now is from our very own guest co-host, DLD Arson. It's called Far From the Average. This is some fresh new stuff, right? No one's heard it?
Set you up. This is the first show, and this is going to be the second single, and we're doing a fat video shoot, and we need like 90% women, so.
Woo!
Oh, so holler at Shirley during the summer, y'all.
Oh. We start picking them up at Redux.
You know what? Look into the camera where Stallion's booth is and tell what you want for that music video shoot again.
We want 90%. Women. And you know who's picking them? My wife.
Ooh.
Oh.
Yay, Donna! That's a smart move.
Audition starts Thursday at Redux.
No, that's what I said. Don't, yeah. We gotta be fine.
So, yeah, when they come up to us and ask for a song, we'll say, you wanna be in a video?
My cousin got an underbite, but she's pretty. She's like, yo. She's mestiza, but.
Oh, man. It's all good. Hey, that's a family hookup.
She'll be sweeping while the pretty girl, too. No, my cousin does got an underbite. We're chipping in. It's a retainer with a bandana. It's a retainer with a bandana for the underbite.
Hey.
Get her mouthpiece. She's a Brentwood, for real. She'll come here later.
Joey Gila, ladies and gentlemen. All right, I want to give a few shout outs to everyone in the chat room. We have Lonnie Marie, we have BTME, we have Scatter Comics, a whole bunch, Liquid Nitro, all in the chat room. You guys want to get a shout out, say something, type in something.
Bane Business, hit me up. You better play my song, fool. Liquid Nitro song.
We'll be right back here on the Slam Show with the exclusive interview with comedian Joey Gila.
Yeah. It's your boy C.I. Rockin' with your boy D.A. And we built a grind, baby. Y'all ready?
Built a grind. Ladies, this is for y'all. Woo! This is for y'all.
above and beyond. Cause I know that you're the one I should be with when I'm out having fun. Vegas, Hawaii, Miami in the sun. Never when you with me sitting shotgun. My runway model when you rock punks. She the cutest when we debate, talk junk. Not to mention that you fit and you got junk. In the trunk, make everybody stir when you in the skirt. Love how you tire her when I be with her and help her with the flirt. She reciprocates, listen babe, all this indicates that we meant to be and this is fate. Why you think I never ever miss a date?
Cause I'm tryna prove that I'm really into you. From here on it's the best, just to know those other dudes.
Hey boo, you ain't got nothing to lose. Don't waste your time with these fools. It's a no-brainer what to do. Different, which makes me wanna go the distance. For the feeling in my stomach, what is this? You know you on top of my wish list. I want it monogamous, it's so obvious. It's more than Pop and Chris. I'm talking about visiting the metropolis of England and go cop and crib. Willing to give up the play of life. Only you who I think about late at night. Day and night, rain or shine, I'll be there, promise you, say hi. Take a leap of faith, I'll lead the way. You're my diamond girl, lead the way. Get sick, I'll be your CNA. Every day we deal, you'll be amazed.
Cause I'm tryna prove that I'm really into you. From here on it's the best, just ignore those other dudes.
Hey boo, you ain't got nothing to lose. Don't waste your time with these fools. It's a no-brainer what to do. Places that you would like. Front beach view, chillin', pouring bubbly. Spontaneously go into foreign countries. What you mean in the happiness? My island, the girl with a Cali twist. Nothing at all like these hacking chicks. I can see you next to me stacking chips. My ride or die, by my side. Take a chance, I rise. Can't help but stare, cause you're mighty fine. I'ma do what it takes to be finally mine. I'll be there for you when the weather's bad. It's a fact, I'm something that you never had. Treat you right to the point you'll forever brag. Saying I'm the best that you ever have.
I'm tryna prove that I'm really into you. From here on it's the best, just ignore those other dudes.
Hey boo, you ain't got nothing to lose. Don't waste your time with these fools. It's a no-brainer what to do.
Others can't. That's why they mistreated.
Yeah, that's brand new DL the Arson. Far from the average, bro. That's the slap.
Right on.
That's
you.
The jam.
Talk about that. How'd you come up with this like freaking slow jam? What's it sound like, Stallion?
Like I old school, LL Cool J,
Jodeci-ish.
No, I kind of feel like more of like island. That's why I got that's CR from CRSB. He's on CMC also. He has that song Live It Up.
Yes. Hey,
you need to get those kids in here. But anyways, that's CR from Vallejo. Mm-hmm. Shout out to them dudes. And it's just it's that's the female category in my album. You know what I mean?
Right. So. It's for the ladies for that grinding at the end of Redux sort of thing.
Is the bonus track?
Hey, however they want to take it.
Right on. Good. Good shit there, Mr. Arson.
Good-ish.
I love it.
Thank you.
Good shit. I don't give a fuck. Good-ish. Yeah. Here we go. All right. This is the exclusive interview segment with our special guest. I'll throw in a little slideshow.
Whoa.
Yeah. This is how he gets down.
Oh, hell no.
Vanilla rice.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a big round of applause once again for Joey Gila.
Yo, hey man, no, seriously, bottom of my heart, man, thank you guys for having me. And I wanted to come way earlier. Mm-hmm. I'm so glad it happened now. Yeah, in the burg, in the place
to
be.
Yeah, don't fake next time, bro.
I know, Filipinos, we're always fake.
Right on. So let's go ahead and talk about Joey Gila. Let's kind of skip a little bit. What made you want to become a comedian and a TV host? Straight up.
You know, as a kid, I was always impersonating, you know. And that's how it all started when I was younger. I used to entertain my cousins and friends by doing accents. And but I never thought I'd be doing it on stage. I used to just do it just to entertain my friends and make them laugh.
Gotcha.
But, you know, I noticed that making people laugh also lighten the moods and make them feel better, whether it's my aunties, uncles, friends, whatever. Mm-hmm. So I knew there was some kind of healing even back then.
Of course.
You know, where I could go into a room and change the energy.
Yeah.
You know, so I just thought I'd just be doing it as a hobby, you know, just for friends, but never thought in a million years I'd be on stage, you know, sharing it to strangers.
When did that start? How old were you?
You know, I started probably doing accents, imitations, probably when I was about 9.
Wow.
Yeah, just imitating. Like, people don't know that I'm half Filipino, and my mom is Burmese, English, Irish, Italian, Spanish.
That's like Stallion.
See? Yeah, I told you.
Italiano. No, but my mom was born in India. So, the Indian accent was my first accent.
You're fucking with us, right?
I swear.
Because that's like some really crazy, yeah, crazy. Ancient so alien shit
I
that you're saying.
I grew up, like, you know, on the Burmese Indian culture Christmas side, Filipino side. But my first accent, like, my grandparents had Indian accents.
Right.
They say, Joy of the bloody ringleader always being very messy. But that's what I heard, you know.
Okay.
Before, you know, the Filipino accent, it was like I knew the Indian accent before.
Oh, really? So it went like in certain chapters in your life how you were presented with these accents. So why are you so fluent? You should be really fucked up by now.
Yeah, right? It's crazy. Because my dad came when he was 3.
Uh-huh.
So my dad doesn't really have an accent. He sounds more like, hey, Joey, you know, check this out, you know.
Sounds like
I grew up in the mission, you know. You know, I'm more Chicano than Pinoy, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's like, that's how he talks. He's very suave, smooth. He's a player, too. That's why they're divorced. But that's
I don't mean to laugh.
Yeah.
Just the way you...
So my fiance Bonnie, man. I got you, man. I got my daddy. I love you. But Pops is a player, man.
Okay.
And he's still funny.
What does he instill into you?
Just his comedy. He's hilarious.
He doesn't instill any playerism?
You know what? I think I've been in long relationships because my dad was a player.
Okay, so...
Yeah, so I saw it as a kid. He used to tell me, this is uncut. He said, don't tell your mom.
Ooh.
Yeah, so I saw that
you
as
know
a
what?
Kid.
My heart dropped on that because that's kind of painful.
Yeah, so
I'm not bullshitting you, man.
I've been in relationships, you know, for a long time to make it work.
Right.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Okay, so you just don't want to be that.
Well, I just know that, you know, you just got to be good to be people. And if you don't want to be in a relationship, you just get out of it. Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
You hear that, Stallion?
Yeah.
Why you gotta throw me under the bus, fucker?
I know. Yeah, these guys are engaged, right? Give a round of applause for being engaged right here. And they work together.
Aw, thank you.
And they sleep together. Yeah. You guys still get hickeys?
And he pulls out.
So you guys get hickeys.
Sam's polite, he pulls out.
I'll tell you this right now. Joey Gila got some motherfucking balls coming on the freaking studio like this. I love you.
I love you too, brother.
When you went into your adulthood, because I know you're a relatively young guy still.
Yes.
What made you say, I'm going to go all out? Because obviously, you don't do anything else but this comedy and your co-host, your hosting thing, right? That's it.
It's your full grind.
Yeah, full grind.
Yes.
Just like DL's song, that grinding sound.
Right.
Did you feel that, hey, this might be a questionable move that I'm trying to do for myself? Because obviously, just like any Filipino parents or anyone with Asian background, they want you to become a nurse, an attorney, stuff like that. Did you have any of that pressure knowing that you're going into an environment where there might not be any insurance, anything to cover you, any 401k? How did you approach that?
Actually, you know, my parents, I guess just because, you know, they came here, you know, my dad came when he was 3, my mom, they're very Americanized, you know.
That helps.
So basically they just said, you know, whatever makes you happy.
Mm.
Not about money. It wasn't about education. It's whatever makes you happy. And I think if kids were given an opportunity, it's like, you know, you find out what your real calling and art and purpose is in life.
Because, you know, if you're making everyone else happy, you're not really happy. So,
well, that's some deep shit.
Well
yeah.
said.
Yeah. Dandis and Bandi. I am the Babemban Palantan. No, I'm just kidding. No. No, it's all about being happy. And, you know, I thank my parents for just letting me be me.
Gotcha. I think that's a really important thing when you have that parent support to kind of say, hey, do what you want, my son, my daughter, and make right. it happen without right. having any ills or
guilt.
Yeah, exactly.
Right, 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 or guilt, yeah.
So let's go with, what do you want to start off first, the whole comedic aspect that you put on the table or the whole mixed network situation? What do you want to talk about?
I just want to talk about how I used to be good in bed. You know what I'm saying? I used to put it down.
Are you using Viagra? Are you using Ohambe? Or what are you using?
I just put Vicks on my taint. That's what I do.
Damn.
I put a cough drop in my put. Go ahead, girl. Go ahead, girl. Put a cough drop in my put. No. You said we could be a little nasty, but
holy
okay.
shit, man. Right. Fucking Vick. He said Vicks.
Yeah, remember Vicks?
Isn't it supposed to, like, burn?
Vicks is bad. You don't get soap in your pee hole.
It said B on it.
Remember when you get soap in your pee hole? And then your shower is there. You got to, like, try to face it.
Yeah.
You get soap in your pee hole. Oh, no. What was the question? I'm sorry. I got ADD, man.
Let's
how you want to be a comedian with soap in your pee hole?
What came first, being on stage for the first time as a comedian or mm-hmm. having this whole network opportunity that fell on your lap? Which one was first?
I used to be a former hairdresser, and I'm straight. I got to say that real fast. Because you know better. So you got Mini Cooper. You got Mini Cooper's pee.
Sam was the first one to spot that one.
Yeah.
They got Mini Cooper right here on 20s.
Trying to get my pager. No, but then, you know, but I became a hairdresser because I knew I needed a trade.
Mm-hmm.
I needed a trade, and my grandfather was a hairdresser. My great-grandfather was. I said, oh, I'm just going to be a barber.
Mm-hmm.
So I went to cosmetology school, and they said, oh, no, you should get into hair color, whatever. That's where the money is. So then I said, oh, okay. So I just started doing that. So my dream was to – so here's something even insightful that I'm going to let you guys know. I'm in remission from cancer, and I had cancer 3 times, and that's the real reason why I became a hairdresser, because I lost my hair. And then the reason I got into comedy is because laughter is medicine.
Yes.
So I used to watch, yeah. comedy and say, you know what? If I could do it, because I used to watch when I was in, you know, going through chemo, I used to watch TV and laugh. And I said, man, this is healing. So those are the two things I wanted to do.
Oh.
Is do hair and then make people laugh.
Oh, straight.
That's what's up.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Well, did you know that, D.L.?
No, I didn't.
Oh,
yeah.
That's dope.
So, yeah, it's beautiful to see people in the crowd laughing because I know it's healing. So absolutely. It's a little bit deeper. I mean, deeper. It's a little bit deeper. It's a little bit deeper than the line when you cook the rice.
Wow. I mean, I'm trying to get back into focusing our mold, and you straight up give us something so real like that.
With
like,
humor.
Yeah.
Yes. That's dope.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Thank you.
And I'm trying to regain our momentum.
No,
here.
I just think that, you know,
it's sort of like a buzzkill, guys. Right, kind of? You know, we'll work through it.
Let's go back to the pill and the quit. All right. The Vicks. No, but that's the whole reason why I do what I do and I love what I do.
Yeah.
So that's behind it. Yeah.
Okay.
I was going to say it, but I had to say it. I was like, oh, I just got to. So hopefully it gives people inspiration.
Exactly. Exactly. That's what the show is about, is for you to be very transparent about everything. That way people can say, hey, watching the Slam Show, seeing Joey Gila on inspired me. Same with DL, same with everyone. And we want to do our thing because we know that they're being upfront. No censoring, no nothing.
And you know what's funny about that? Oh, sorry, not to cut you off. Is my brother is a hairdresser. He owns a salon. He's straight. You know what I mean?
Right.
Oh, yes,
he said that strong, too.
Give a plug.
Hey, shout out to my brother and the whole A-Logo Salon. Man, no, you know, when he started, you know, just like, you know, it reminded me when you said, you know, I'm straight, but this is what I wanted to do. Because a lot of people, they go, like, you mean a barber, right? People are like, no, I mean a hairdresser. But, you know, he doing this thing. And, you know, what I see when I go there is girls be feeling like they ready for the red carpet. After he finishes doing it, and that's the job for a hairdresser, a barber, whatever. So you know, that's what's up.
Yeah, right.
Hey, speaking of carpet, did you ever get dye a carpet?
dye a carpet. Oh, you mean like matching drapes?
Yeah.
Nah, I just trim carpet. That's
all. Okay. So you really have trimming up down there?
Yeah. Just one side. Okay. Like salt and pepper. Just one on this side. Let this grow.
Okay, cool.
Leave this grow. Oh.
So as far as the hairdressing thing, is that something you could go back to if you wanted to?
Or you know, I could. Only thing is it's pretty toxic with the chemicals.
Yeah.
You know, so if you're in an environment of smelling that color all day, you know, it's not healthy. And that's why I choose not to do it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but
yeah, I don't think they make a low VOC, volatile organic compound, VOC, with, you know, hair color. Mm-hmm. They need to start doing that. They do that with paints.
Right.
But they don't do it with color or straightening elements.
It's expensive. Yes. They have some, but it's real expensive.
How long did you were you in the business for?
You know, I total maybe about almost 5 years.
Wow.
I worked in Maiden. I was on Maiden Lane in San Francisco at a spot called Joseph Koza, and then I worked at Beverly Hills at Jose Bear Salon. Ooh. And then while I was there, I saw Jerry Seinfeld come in, and my boy was cutting his hair, because there used to be a lot of stars coming to the salon. But I would look at him, I said, man, that's a brother right there that did comedy, started acting, and is living his dream. So I was like, kind of just I didn't say hi, I was just staring at him, and I was like, oh man, maybe one day. And then right after I saw him, I just took a comedy class.
Okay.
In LA, some crash comedy class. It was like in a little, like, what's it called? Like a little trailer.
Really?
Yeah, it was next to someone, it was next to like people learning English. So you could hear them learning English. Like, my name is Manuel.
You mean an ESL class?
Yeah. But this class led to me. This class led to me. ESL Spanish class.
So you guys teaching how to make people laugh, and they next door learning how to speak English.
Right.
Clown on everybody,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah. So then from there, the good thing that came out of that was that there was a showcase night in LA, and in a place called the Haha.
Mm-hmm.
And and that's how it kind of started. Was I stepped on stage and started riffing with people, making them feel good, and it was kind of like a rush after that.
Okay, so this was the first time you were on stage.
Yes.
Did you have any type of plan, any script, anything you're working with?
I didn't have anything, and I didn't want to go to that class. I didn't want to show up that night because I wasn't prepared.
Ooh, okay.
So they were like, "No, you just gotta go. Just go up there." And I said, "No, I don't want to, because I didn't do my homework."
Mm-hmm.
So basically, I went up there and just kind of riffed on what I saw.
Freestyle?
Yeah, because that's what I used to do with my friends. Back in the day, we were in a graffiti group called K-Sun. All we do was graffiti. Just tap on each other. Graffiti. Yeah, but I wasn't one. I didn't do a lot of the tagging. I just help hold the paint.
So. Yeah. Help mix the paint?
Yeah, this was like, you know.
Help buy the paint?
Yeah. In circles, all we did was cap on each other for hours. That's all we did was cap on each other.
Okay.
So. But, you know, it actually worked your freestyle mind on how to think fast.
Yeah.
See, so when I got on, basically just answering all my questions here.
Yeah. So when I get on stage and I see someone or they say something, I could say something back. There's no hesitation. Like you guys on radio, eventually all these years, right away, it just comes.
Natural.
Know, everything just comes natural, right? And I didn't even know I'd be preparing myself for comedy. But, you know, just being kids and being goofy.
Gotcha. Yeah. So how did this whole mix TV show situation come upon you?
When I was modeling. No, I'm joking.
Oh, that's messed up. You lie.
No,
it's
true.
No, I was actually performing. I think we had a show in Marine World. It was, I think it was Kababayan Fest.
Yeah.
And I was just performing.
Yeah.
Yeah, and there's a producer for Mix.
Okay.
Anthony Garcia. Said, hey, you got to come by Mix, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Come by Mix and check it out.
What year was this?
This was like in 2007.
Wow.
2007.
Damn, 5 years ago.
Yeah.
Half a decade.
Yeah.
Come on.
And then I was invited to just check out this cartoon called The Nut Shack. And I was like, what is Nut Shack? And they're like, oh, you know, it's like a Filipino-themed, you know, animation cartoon. Like,
you know what? I think I have that DVD somewhere.
Oh, do you really?
Yeah.
But that's the wrong kind of Nut Shack, Sam.
That's right.
That's just
right.
Nuts. That's good.
It's just nuts.
X, X, X.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. So they asked me if I could do some, you know, can I do voices? I go, yeah, I could do some voices. So I was able to do, like, probably 6 characters on the cartoon. Yeah.
Wow.
Which was fun. Yeah. So from there, they'd asked me if I wanted to host a TV show. So I said, what kind of TV show? They go, oh, like a music video. Like, oh, yeah, okay. They go, think of a name. I go, that's my jam. Because, you know, that's what we say, right?
Right, right, right.
Man, that's my jam.
Yeah.
I thought it was going to be urban. I thought it was going to be soulful. But, man, it was like Korean pop and stuff. They're like, Seju, Gongju, Seungji, Jeonju, Baby's Daddy, Gongju, no. No, but it was like a mix. I thought it was going to be soul, you know? Like, you know, because, you know, I grew up on R&B soul. I thought we were going to have more.
Yeah,
rap,
you thought it was like another CMC.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Yeah,
and it's like, no, it's going to be pop. It's going to be music that I've never heard of. Like,
what you know about that, DL?
Home Turf.
Home Turf.
With Dominique.
Yeah. Frisco right there.
Yeah, that's it. Unfortunately, DL is the youngster here.
What's
so
Home Turf?
If you know Home Turf.
No, see, the Home Turf, I was thinking was the one on KBL.
No. We're talking about...
Oh, no. No, before that.
Yeah, see, that's the one I'm talking
this
about.
This is when Braces first came out. This was when the...
Damn.
Dominique.
Yeah.
So you were on This My Jam, and how'd that evolve?
We did it for 2 years.
Okay.
And we had some cool artists on there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so basically it was a music countdown. Every once in a while, music artists come. I interview them.
Mm-hmm.
And one of my first interviews were... I think it was Bieber, Justin Bieber. Or a second interview was Justin Bieber.
What? I'm laughing because you're
yeah,
because
it was before he actually, you know,
what was he
was popping.
What
he was
he
just
like,
popping.
Like two?
Yeah, he was young.
Was in
know,
a sack.
Kid, I saw him, you know, he performed live. I was impressed.
Are you
like,
fucking kidding us?
No,
or
it was
straight
at
up.
City Nights.
It was Justin Bieber.
Yeah, I interviewed him at City Nights.
What?
At City Nights. It was crazy.
YouTube this.
Yeah, exactly.
Yep.
Yeah, there has to be some evidence.
Yeah. I'll show you a picture. I'll show you a picture.
Wow.
Yeah. No, I think we got the interview. It might be even online.
Okay, cool.
Yep.
All right. So, the
Anything
recent...
No, I'm just kidding.
The recent programmings of Mix have been, I would say, quality. You have quality discussion... good acts, good topics, and hot co-hosts.
Yes, I was just about to say that.
Let's talk about...
Are we talking about the slam show?
Well, we're probably like the second hot ones.
Yeah.
The first one that you had, Olivia.
Yes.
She was your buddy. Yeah, let's talk about that because there's a... You know, everyone likes tuning in to hot chicks when they see them on the tube, especially if they're Panay.
She's Japanese white.
Oh, is
Olivia.
She?
Olivia's Japanese and white. Okay. But everyone thought she was Filipino.
Yeah.
But no. But they even nominated her like something about sexiest Panay whatever. and we were laughing at her. I'm like, damn, this girl's Hapa. She's not even Panay.
And she just rolled with it, right?
She was just laughing. She was a good sport.
Yeah, she goes, I'll take the award and just like kind of sharpie it over and put the actual nationality. So do you feel that having... a good female co-host brings another element to you when you're doing the
it does. She was really, really experienced too, because she hosts like two or three shows before we got together.
Mm-hmm.
So I hosted a show, she hosted a show, so together it was like just finding the chemistry.
Gotcha.
And it just worked, you know. I feel like, you know, she's just like my sister,
right?
You know, we're just BSing, and very, very intelligent girl, very smart.
Excellent.
Like she's very techie. She knows a lot about, you know, as a matter of fact, she has her own site too.
Yeah,
OliviaTech.com.
Yeah, is it her own blog?
Yeah, her own blog. And she's got like tons of fans, and they're doing legit stuff, like high tech stuff.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna rely on you to get her on the show. All right, on the next girl, the next female co-host, she's equally as hot. What's her name?
What's her name, man?
No, I'm kidding.
Is it
Keiko Olivia's? Yeah.
Yeah,
that's my sister right there.
Yeah, talk about how this relationship is working. Versus how things were with Olivia. Is it the same chemistry?
Both
dynamic?
Both different. Both are different. I mean, we both have fun. Either way, Keiko just came in raw with no experience.
Right.
So it was just
like a virgin to the whole thing.
Throwing her in.
Freaking tight virgin about the whole thing.
Whoa. So you're saying she
didn't say
out.
That, babe. I didn't say that, babe. I don't even look at my car. I close my eyes. No.
That sounds familiar. You just get thrown in there and said, say hi to the camera.
Right. But, you know, there was a lot of girls that tried out. Seriously.
A lot
of girls. And, you know, we were, my producers, I think they're trying to find someone that could, you know, once Olivia was gone, they're like, oh, man, what the hell are we going to do now, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So they did this search. People were sending in tapes from all over. And we just picked like 12 that shined,
right?
And went through this crazy interview process.
Mm-hmm.
It was like two or three interviews. Made them do, you know, like actual interviews. Had them interview me.
Right.
So I like to work on the spot. You know, put them in. You know, just a lot of improv too. And there were a lot of them were good.
Right.
You know, Keiko just fit the part the best though. And she did awesome, and she did amazing as we taped.
Yeah, that's
for
cool.
Having no TV experience too.
That's great. That's when you have a little gem there. And for everyone out there, just YouTube or Google Olivia Esperanza and Keiko, right?
Yeah, Keiko Alingus.
To know exactly what we're talking about, these females are, yeah, dime pieces.
Brother, your girl is right here. You say she's a dime piece right now, or there's going to be a fight.
Oh, there's no.
I'm just kidding. I'm just trying to start a fight.
I like hot girls as well, but I'm straight.
You guys are a good-looking couple, though, for real.
Well, thank you.
For real. You guys are a good-looking couple.
Man, you are going to be invited back tomorrow, dude.
For a threesome.
With you three. And me.
Stallion's down. Huh, Stallion?
No.
Well, check this out. So, what you're putting on the table, being a comedian, being a show host, what is more gratifying out of all these duties that just says, this is me?
You know, actually, my love is stand-up. My love is stand-up. You know, that's what I like to do.
Really?
Sitting.
But, you know, being able to put stand-up on TV and to be myself is even better, because I'm not, like, the script is not written, you know, it's not a robotic script.
Yeah.
And a lot of it's freestyle.
Just like us.
Yeah, shouts out to Josh, one of our writers, and our producer, Roland Posadas, and John Santos, our cameraman, the whole mixed-rated crew. I love you.
No,
but a bunch of cool people to work with, right? And I think just having fun, like you guys, it's just having fun and putting something on TV that we didn't even know how it was gonna look like, but somehow it just kind of meshed together and Mixed Rated came about.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Gotcha. To my co-host, I'm going to say one more question, and after that, you guys have a chance to ask Jovi something.
This ain't truth or dare, right?
Not yet.
Not yet.
We'll get there. Now, as far as, like, the negative dark side of the business, what really stands out that makes you kind of say, fuck, this really makes me think about what I'm trying to do here, and it's just, like, almost making you want to quit and move on to something else. What would be that experience?
Well, it's just learning about business. You know, there's
politics.
Yeah, there's doing stuff about, you know, like being an entertainer or working on your craft and your art. That's the only thing you really should work on.
Mm-hmm.
But then if you don't have a manager, you don't have an agent, which I don't now, it's like just learning how to deal with people. And, you know, the way I come at people is just letting them know that, you know, I don't consider it a deal. I want to make something, you know, I don't even like calling it business. I just consider it like, it's almost like a love transaction, you know?
Right, right.
You know, you do me good, I'll do you good.
Gotcha.
And on good faith, that's the way I work with someone again. It's just, you know, just how I'm being treated, how I'm being invited.
Right, right.
Because, you know, I want to give them the best product possible.
Yeah.
So
if someone uses you, it's like...
Yeah, then you know.
Yeah.
Right, but you always give someone the benefit of the doubt. Because I want to, you know, I always sit down and imagine... you know, good transactions and, you know, meeting good people. So, you know, like, he knows about The Secret, just about manifesting good things in your life. So if I always think positive things, I hope to attract that kind of energy, that kind of people around me.
Excellent.
Yeah. So well I come said. Out with that way of thinking.
Well said. Because usually that question would be answered, well, there was this situation, blah, blah, blah. But you kind of like gave it a little spin, a positive spin, regardless of how negative it turned out. Good stuff there, Joey.
Oh, definitely. Thank you, brother.
Lady Sage, throw something at him.
Quick question. You pretty much answered throughout your interview what I wanted to ask. But on your free time, what do you like to do? Do you volunteer, get back to the community, or you just like freaking relax? You're built to L, like you said earlier.
You know, on my downtime when I'm not traveling, actually, I spend it at home, you know, with my girl.
Nice.
And I got a little French bulldog, you know. Every once in a while I'm able to volunteer and host something, you know, when I can.
Mm-hmm.
But there's just so many, there's only certain ones that you can pick, because everyone wants you for free, you know?
Right.
And if you do everything for free, it's like you got to pay your rent and, you know, so just as long as you're doing enough, you know, just to have that good rotation
gotcha.
Of giving back, you know? But, you know, every once in a while I do try to, you know, help out a charity, do something for free.
Nice.
You know, wash a rim for free. No, I'm just kidding.
He said a rim. Yeah, rim, yeah, just like one.
Just wash you one rim.
What's his name?
And yeah. Another quick question. As far as your comedy act, I know there is structure, but is it based on experience? Like, you know, you talk about your family or friends, or
is it totally fake?
Exactly.
It's just exaggerated truth.
Gotcha.
You know, we went to the club. I'll just add so much stuff to it. You know, it's just, and you know, a lot of people talk about pain, you know, and they turn pain into positive. I haven't tapped that yet, because everything I've been living so far has been mostly positive.
That's good.
So I'm only calling as I see it.
Yeah.
You know, and just, you know, I'm not the smartest dude. I didn't go to college. I went to beauty school, you know. So I just make people laugh in the way that I know how, that I've been doing for years with friends.
Gotcha.
So I just make sure that everyone in the audience feels like they're more like family, you know, rather than just a stranger they paid to see.
Yeah.
So I try to have a deeper connection with them.
I like it.
Yeah.
Excellent, excellent. Stallion, throw something at him.
So who's the very first comedian you ever saw on TV that you weren't allowed to watch?
Oh, weren't allowed to watch.
Whoa. You know, good question.
I was pretty much allowed to watch anything. Like, they didn't say don't watch this. But I remember...
It's very typical of Filipino or Asian parents to say, don't watch that.
Right.
It's bad for
right.
you. You learn bad.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it was Eddie Murphy.
Yeah.
And I laughed so hard. Before that, I'm so sorry. Actually, it wasn't... Well, he's kind of a comedian. Cheech Marin was Up in Smoke.
Yeah. Ooh, classic.
Oh, my God. I never laughed so hard. I said, man, that something about that show is hilarious.
Mm.
But that was my first funny, like, movie. But it was Eddie Murphy.
You're like, oh, that's hella good.
Yeah, we used to be watching Andrew Dice Clay.
Oh, you
at the school?
No way.
Yeah, way back in the day, like 87 and 88.
Right, right. Yeah, Clay. Whew.
Yeah, Andrew Dice.
The Dice Man.
He's kind of laboring right now. DL, throw something at Mr. Geely.
Man, bro, well, first and foremost, man, congrats on all your success, man. I see you everywhere, you know what I mean, and
oh,
your
man,
shows and your name, and that's what's up, you know, just to see another Filipino brother doing his thing. And it's your 9-to-5, like you said, and you know, man, you're there, you know what I mean, you're doing what you want to do. So what were the struggles and stuff, the ups and downs that you just had to grind out to get to where you're at?
Well, just a lot of it, as a starting comedian, is finding where you can perform, you know, finding where you perform. But when I moved back to the Bay Area, is like certain big clubs, you couldn't just go up and perform there, right?
Yeah.
So there was a friend of mine, his name is Tony Sparks. He's like, hey, man, why don't you come out to Oakland? You know, I'll put you on, you know, it was Kimball's East.
Oh, okay.
Kimball's East, yeah. So Kimball's East was one of like the first venues I really worked at, so I didn't really have to grind at like coffee houses and, you know,
bottom of the barrel stuff.
Yeah, but no, that's where you're supposed to start.
Yeah.
And that's where, but I was fortunate enough for someone to give me an opportunity.
That's what's
and
up.
Then so I started, you know, using that as my, you know, like my main spot, you know, performed a few times, and they had this big competition called the Kings of Comedy, which was put out by Walter Latham. And you know the original Kings of Comedy?
Yeah, yeah.
The founder had this competition, and I only been doing comedy like less than a year, maybe 10 months. So it was at Kimball's East. So I was like, oh my gosh! So all these amazing comedians flew in to have this competition in different states, California, whatever. So I went to go watch, and someone's like, oh, just go. So I end up just entering, and then I won.
That's what's up.
But they were like, it was like Apollo, like, whoa, 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 whoa. And I was like, damn, this is for real. And, you know, but just starting off, you know, I started off performing, you know, for a Black American audience. So
yeah.
I felt comfortable to just be myself and you know, because, you know, when you work with a Black audience, they're very honest.
Oh, yeah.
Mm. You know, they wouldn't even introduce you by your name. You're like, coming to the stage, Spanish dude. You're like, damn, that's my intro? And they'll scream out, go ahead, La Bamba. Go ahead, La Bamba.
They thought you were Spanish?
Yeah, they just think I'm Spanish if I wasn't. And then, you know. Yeah, they're like, I mean, I've seen stuff at Oakland that was just uncut. It was raw. Like, I saw a guy bombing on stage, and I was at the bar watching. I said, I feel bad. And it was quiet, and this old Black man goes, kill yourself! And I cried so much. I was laughing so hard. But that's... But that, yeah, those were the scary days, though.
Gotcha. Well, so, hey, that's real, and you are a very real person coming on the show, saying what you have to say and sharing those experiences with us.
Oh, thank you.
We greatly appreciate
guys.
That.
Thank you, guys.
Right on, right on.
That's my camera. I gotta look sexy.
Oh yeah, there you go. There's your camera. There you go. Give that sexy smile.
Yeah.
We're going to go ahead and take a quick music break, and we're going to give you the vaunted Q&A. You're going to like this.
I love that.
You gotta, this one is, how should I say, the Stallion?
Is this X-rated again?
Yes, it is.
X-rated
again? We're a bunch of pervs.
They slammed Fresco, but...
We are a bunch of pervs.
We'll be right back.
They're not ready to go, Virgin, right?
The second part with Joey Gila. Hang tight.
Love you guys.
That position depends on the situation. Three ball in my mouth like I'm a dentist patient. I got a vision, she ain't in front of that. My mama asked me how I get it, cause I'm a f***ing act. In the jeans, her look so fat, fat, fat before you. I'ma play with that cat, cat, cat. Okay, you know my name, you know my gang, it's 400, you down. And she was f***ing, that's the only reason I was f***ing with. I love my nigga, know that I love my clit. I be bad, bad, man, I love my nigga. I hold the city down, real haters on my head. Switch. I be in the streets where it get real sick. 4 minutes when the girls have to feel just
dream. Calling happy, your name Tati. Tell me what it do, tell me what it do, what it do, what it do, what it do. I'm a cold, getting igloo. Calling happy, your name Tati. Tell me what it do, what it do, what it do, what it do, what it do. I'm a cold, getting igloo.
Yeah, that's a little I Am Sue brand new igloo. Joey Gila, you're feeling that.
Oh, damn.
That was a slap.
That was the ooh.
That was the ooh.
That sound to make you go ooh.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm.
It's like borderline caca.
Ooh. Oh, gosh. Here we go. Welcome back to the Slam Show. This is the second part of the interview. We're going to go straight into the Q&A, the vaunted segment where everyone kind of has... To be transparent about answering these questions, we're going to go right into it. I will kick it off. Number one, Mr. Gila.
Yes, sir.
How many girls have you slept with, roughly and truthfully?
One and a half.
You know, you put it in halfway. What?
You put it in halfway. Now, how many girls have I been with or had girlfriends?
Yeah, get a little bit closer to the mic,
put
please.
Put it in halfway.
How many girls have I been with?
Slept with.
Oh, slept with?
Yeah.
He's like, I don't want to answer this. My girl's listening.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, well. You know, have I to don't tell. Know.
Just give one. Just say one.
So many. Itchy? No, I'm just kidding. No.
Itchy, scratchy.
Wow.
Four.
Okay.
That's a good name. That's a good number, huh?
All right.
Is it a D on the end?
Yeah.
All right. Have you slept with more than one girl within a 12-hour span?
No. But I will.
Number three.
I like these questions.
At what age did you lose your virginity?
17.
Oh, damn. I didn't even finish my
Right in
my
your
sentence.
Eye. I'm looking at you, too. You know where it was. In school? Carl's Jr. parking lot. No, I was playing.
I was wow. Playing.
No, I was at Carl's Jr.
Okay.
At the Goya Lux. How often do you visit the strip club?
Visit? Like it's church.
I visit the strip club.
I visit the strip club. I don't really go to strip clubs. Last time was probably about 6 years ago, and the strippers were sick, too.
Sick? Yeah. Meaning, like, not feeling well?
Like she had four kinds of that's with a diaper. I was like, man, she got stomach flu? She got stomach flu.
Hey, do they be like, Joey's here. He's going to make it rain.
I know.
Skeet.
Strip clubs. You guys like strip clubs?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You like strip clubs?
Yeah, we went together.
That's cool.
It was awesome. Vegas.
Oh, in Vegas?
Yeah.
That's dope.
Yeah, you're like thinking, oh my God, I'm just living my life right now.
Damn, I'm about to go with my girl's strip club tonight.
Brass rail.
Yes.
Sure there's one in every town.
Number five. What's your favorite alcoholic beverage?
Batiste.
That shit's so bad for
Batiste
you.
Batiste is hella good. I don't care if my cheeks swell. I love Batiste. No, I like goose and tonic because it's clean.
Okay.
It's low calorie. You could control your buzz with goose and tonic, you know? Hennessy, you'd be wanting to like, you be able to do some things, you know? You drink Hennessy, you'd be like, why you take off your socks? Go to the club, bro. Why you take off your socks? Take off your socks.
All right. Have you ever touched a girl's ass in a club?
No. You mean just go up to a strange girl and grab her booty?
Yeah.
Or like grab it and say he did it.
Or she did it.
Yeah. I used my feet one time.
What?
From a distance too.
Grab her ass and turn around and say I'll do it again.
Yeah.
Keep walking, I'll do it again.
Here's one.
She's in a cage at DV8.
We'll scratch that question.
He's at DV8.
At DV8? That's when I had a thin dress tie.
When you were doing hair, did you ever look down a girl's shirt?
You know what? Ooh. Wait, let me see.
How can you? They put a cape on you.
Yeah,
but when they're, you know, you're laying back and you're washing your hair and stuff.
Mm. Oh, right. Right.
Right.
I dropped
the
cum in the shirt by accident.
No, for real. Your mouth open?
Yeah, I chew like a sister. Just like I'm grazing.
Well, I got you wet a little bit.
Yeah.
That's funny. All right. Number seven.
I smelled the cleavage by accident. I went to tie my shoe and it was right there.
You're disgusting.
Donk.
What's the most kinkiest place you had sex at?
Kinkiest place I ever had sex.
Yes.
It was at the zoo, San Francisco Zoo.
Oh.
Yeah. San Francisco Zoo.
Wow. Doesn't it stink?
It was by the blind cheetah. He didn't even see me. It was by the.
Oh.
They got a blind cheetah. No, Oakland Zoo got a blind cheetah. It was the Oakland Zoo. It was the Oakland Zoo, the blind cheetah. It got a stick and everything. Just. No, you do. You think I'm lying?
Yes.
A blind cheetah in Oakland Zoo.
It's where you had sex at.
Right behind the blind cheetah cage. By the one-armed parrot.
Arm.
Oh, brother.
Dude, none of these answers are freaking true. Yeah. Fucked up.
I'm going to flip it on him, Sam.
Go ahead.
Which three Built the Grind celebrities would you like to have sex with?
Say women.
Okay. Which three celebrities?
Oh, three celebrities I like to sex with? Okay.
Yeah.
Right now?
Man.
All right, here we go. All right, here we go. Dang.
Don't say Johnny Depp.
Yeah.
I did his hair.
What's Cher's son on Mask? What's his name?
Oh, Rocky. I am not
Rocky
the animal.
You had the long face. That boy had the oblong face. I want you, player. That's my dream.
Oh,
that's Rocky.
That's that one. Who else? Three celebrities. Let's see. Mike Tyson's mom.
Oh, oh wow.
She's fine now.
She's fine now.
And Martin Yan. Yan can cook. That brother, right there. That brother can cook after we do it. All I have to say is two words, chow fun.
He hasn't aged. He still looks the same.
Ain't that crazy how he's like.
You've been watching reruns, that's why. You should see his ass now. Oh, look at Mr. Miyagi. Oh, my God.
Yeah, Scotty might be right.
Yeah, you saw reruns.
Whatever.
Chow fun. We're going to roll right into this one. It's perfect.
Yeah.
Perfect.
More sex questions. It's too easy.
Number 9. Have you ever had a bromance?
Oh. Right now, blood. With your nice caterpillar eyebrows.
Wow. He threads them.
What's a bromance? That's. You mean if I put it in somebody? What the hell is bromance? If I let someone pick on my icky hole?
No.
What is a bromance? Define a bromance and I'll let you know.
The real definition is a man.
One cup, two straws.
One cup. Like, did we rub tanks and cause fireworks? But
do you want the stallion definition or mine?
I want both. This is why I answer this.
You go to a movie and you're like, Sam would go watch a Rock movie and go, damn, that's The Rock.
That's Buckla-ism. That's
pretty much what bromance is.
No.
Tipping, call it a day.
Bromance is like you have a male companion and that you guys are just cool. You like hanging out. You like just you know, having that.
It's borderline bading.
Do
you guys do each other's hair?
If I tried to lick it? Is that what you said?
No. Did you guys do each other's hair?
There's no sticking it in and there's no licking it. There's no fluids being changed.
Oh, like you almost. Oh, like we're wrestling but naked? Is that what you're trying to say? We're wrestling with naked.
Dang. You know, you're like in beauty school. Hey, Bill, hook me up. I'll hook you up too.
So, do you have any male friends that are on that level?
Let me think. Look at me, dude. You know who you are. Hello, John? John Nielsen, is that you? I was kidding. Shout out to my boy, John Nielsen. He might be watching.
Oh,
my
man.
My brother's a. He's a former Raider quarterback, and he's one of my homies. But he sponsors me too, and he hooks me up with all my gear on Mixed Rated or whatever.
Oh, cool!
He's a good brother. No, I get him on the show too.
Okay.
But he rolls with Boyz II Men, and he does stuff for Boyz II Men and New Edition.
All right.
Yeah.
So he's at the county fair a lot
to get on here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Well,
John, are they having a concert soon?
Yeah. I'll give him his information so you can check him out.
Yeah, Boyz II Men with Cash Peak or something, right?
Then we'll do a track with DL.
Yeah.
He's all, who's Boyz II Men?
He's really close with Ralph T, too. Oh,
okay.
Yeah. Okay.
With Ralph. And he's the one who hooked me up with this bag right here. Oh, wow. Power bag.
That's what's up.
Right here. Go to mypowerbag.com. You can do this. Check this out. You can charge your iPhone. Bam. Right here. You can charge your GPS. Yes. Mypowerbag.com. My boy Nick sent me this.
You better get John like Nielsen. 10 of those to give away right now.
Yeah! But it's dope though. You always need a charge. Seriously, this charged my phone hella fast.
Is that also a cooler so you could put liquid nitro in there?
Nice charge.
Does the bag actually charge itself? You got
yeah,
the
look
bag
at this. There's a battery. You just
you walk around with like extension cord and shit.
And then look at that. It shows.
I need a 50 footer.
That's dope. Let's retail on it.
Yeah. But yeah, check this out right there. See, that's the light. Tells you how much charge you have left.
How much does it go for?
I think it's about, I don't know if it's about $1.30, $1.50.
Okay.
Now, what's the
backpack discount too that I have. It's dope.
What's the Joey Gila price?
Yeah. Player's price. Thank you, Nick. Thank you, John Nielsen. My power bag.
Next week, we want those.
Yeah.
Wear them.
Before I forget, also, you asked me where I was earlier. I was at my uncle's karate school in Antioch. It's called Gila's Kajikembo Kickboxing. And if you guys into like Muay Thai kickboxing, my uncle's trained like top kickboxers from Hawaii, and he migrated over here, so he has a good school at Antioch. But one of his fighters, she's dope, a little Pinay, she goes by the name of Katrina the Storm Nahi. Huge fight coming up. She has the kickboxing world title. She's got like 5 or 6 belts.
Ooh.
This is her right here.
It's a girl fight.
Yeah, it's a girl fight. These it's a you got both of these girls fight like dudes. Seriously.
Nice.
And it's You get your tickets at Gila's Kajukenbo Kickboxing.
Joey.
And
Joey.
Yeah.
This stop, is please. You're gonna have a chance to plug it. We got one more question.
This is my auntie. It's my uncle. Yeah, but no. No, you're fine. There's girls that are fighting.
Hold on, motherfucker. You're gonna have a chance to plug it after the break. Close out with the final question.
Yeah. Right, go ahead. Plug in your bag. Have you ever videotaped yourself having sex with yourself?
With myself?
No.
With myself?
On my iPhone. Let me show you.
iPhone?
My pony. Let's do it. Ride it. No. You know what? You know, I always wanted to. I think I still can. But I wanted like to be 3D though, so the penis look bigger. Oh. Just be like, bam. And you just watch your 3D glasses and it'll just hit you right here.
Joey Kilo.
No, I haven't though. Have you?
Yes.
Wow, where do you think all these fucking cameras came from?
How was it?
The bedroom.
How was it watching yourself, though? Do you get better as performance? You know, do you watch, you critique yourself? You're like, man, I need to wax my asshole.
I don't know. I'm not going to answer until DL answers first.
You ever feel yourself?
No. That's evidence. That's how I always thought about it.
I'm not going to answer until DJ Stallion answers.
Oh. Hey, man. I know why all these video cameras in here started from. That's why you got so many bastos.
I don't know what
you know what's going on for the show. You guys start a whole new show.
A whole new show. There ain't no sofa camera.
Oh, we're revealing too much here on the Slam Show.
A lot of interviews on that sofa.
Oh, shouts out to ISIS. Anyways,
paranoia on that sofa.
Joey Gila, thank you very much for being very truthful and comedic about the whole Q&A.
Hey, brother, that was fun, man.
Oh, dude. We got still one more segment
left.
You
want to just pull it out? Fuck it.
We're going to go ahead and take one final music break and be back with the shouts and plugs and also our giveaway. And we got something for the giveaway from Built to Grind. Everyone hang tight here on the Slam Show.
Yeah.
Joy. What the bamboo suit?
Kanye West.
Yeah.
Swag King Kong. Yeah. Yeah. Do you get money anymore. Tell Peter my mink is dragging on the floor. Can I have a bad chick without no flaws? Come to meet me without no draws. Dinner with Anna Winter, racing with Anya Rubik. I told you, mom, the ups, it was more than the music in the projects. One day, the project one way, we done heard all that loud ass talking. We used to it from the shorties, fucked up, double pumped up. Might even kill somebody in YouTube it. Do whatever thinking words affect me is too stupid. And if you can do it better than me, then you do it. We fly in the parakeet, loving with the parachute. $6,000 parachute, we made it to the Paris. No. Talk about staff, cause I embarrass you. Shut the fuck up when you talk to me, fly, embarrass you. Can a young nigga get money anymore? Tell Peter my mink is dragging on the floor. Can I have a bad chick without no flaws? Come to meet me without no draws. In the whole industry, wanna fuck your old chick. Only making I get respect for his whiz. And I'll admit I fell in love with Kim. Around the same time she had fell in love with him. Well that's cool, baby girl, do your thing. Lucky I ain't had Jay dropping from the team. My familiar, New Rock Nation. We in the building, I still keep it basement. Flying in the parakeet, floating with no parachute. $6,000 parachutes, I made it to the Paris. Don't talk about style, cause I embarrass you. Shut the fuck up when you talk to me, for I embarrass you. Good music and fresh, refresh. Anything else we detest, detest. Skip ass niggas, get ass and breast. All that said, let me ask this question. Can a young nigga get money anymore? Tell Peter my mink is dragging on the floor. Can I have a bad chick without no flaws? Come to meet me without the talking about style. Then I'm awfully fucking embarrassed you. Talking about clothes, I'm awfully fucking embarrassed you. Calling about some hoes, I'm awfully fucking embarrassed you. Way too cold, I promise you need some therapy. Get the therapy. Get the devil flu. This Chicago nigga, Southside, we in this shit. Eastside crazy, blow that loud. Low end, 39th, the Ickies, 47th Street, Garfield Park, 79th, Stony Island, 19th.
That's a little Kanye West Therapy featuring DJ Khaled and DJ Paris. Wow, that's a slap right there.
That's my jam.
Yeah, that is.
That's
like
going to rob a liquor store.
Blow pops. All right, this is the Slam Show Shouts and Plug segment. Let's go ahead and take it away, Lady Sage.
All right, first and foremost, I want to wish my goddaughter, April, a happy 21st birthday. Yeah! So everybody say happy birthday.
Happy birthday, April.
Love
Drink
you.
It up.
We'll see you soon. Of course, our special guest, Joey Gila. Our special guest co-host, DL the Arson, and the entire Built to Grind family.
Thank you.
And, of course, Perfect Tan, Kimmy Ann, Jocelyn, and Norbert. Vuku Vaka, shout out to you, Rich Cabell, Team Love Hate, Scatter Comics, and Edmund Fong. Shout out to all you guys. Nice. And, of course, to all our sponsors, we appreciate you guys equally.
There you go. There you Chill. Go. Yeah. Yeah. Well said. Let's go to the booth with DJ Stallion.
Yeah, what's up? I'm still laughing over here in the corner. We're talking about blip pops.
Blip pops.
All right, we're going to go down the line. Special guest host, DL, what's up? Thanks for coming out.
Hold on, thank you.
Lady Sage, Built the Grind crew. Joey, what's up, man?
Thanks for
coming out. Good meeting you. I'm going to go down to Goldilocks and get that hookup you're talking about later. Our sponsors. This guy's going crazy in front of me right now. We got Mellows, Kinders. Thanks for the hookup tonight. Fig Tree, Vuku, Natural Life Foods, Liquid Nitro, Perfect Tan, Niner Empire, Drinkware. And online, we're listening right now is Savage, Meredith, and my parents.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
My mom, dad.
So we can say the fuck, shit, and balls, and all that kind of stuff.
And potatoes.
All good.
Hey, I didn't mean to miss out my entire crew. Slam and Sam, DJ Stallion, and Johnny Ringo. Woohoo!
Yeah.
Woo!
And don't forget, this Thursday, I'll be at Redux all night long, kicking it. And then we'll be back there on Saturday, me and Slam and Sam in the main room.
Yes, yes.
Doing our thing. Built the Grind will be in the house.
Yeah. Better be. Part two. Shop, bring it back. Shop. Part two, Orville.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Built the Drink.
Built the Drink. Let's go, DL. What's your plugs and shots?
Hey, first and foremost, right off for inviting me again.
You're welcome.
You know, Stallion, Sage.
Thank you.
Slam and Sam. Joey, shout out to the special guest Joey, my whole Built to Grind crew, the guys that's here, Orville Jr. Special shout out to my wife and Heads, because the reason why they're actually not here, Donna was actually co-directing the last part of the next video that's about to drop.
Ooh.
On Mother's Day. And shout out to everybody that helped out, A Lago Salon. Jen, that was acting in it, Chloe, the kids, Andrew, just everybody that was part of the video shoot that I wasn't there today. So shout out to y'all, and just everybody tuned in. Right on.
Nice, nice. Well said, well said. Let's go to the couch with our special guest, Joey Gila. Take it away. Take your time, bro.
There's that beatbox we talked about back in Vallejo High.
Shout out!
Yo, man! Hello to all you guys here, man. Give us a round of applause. Seriously, thank you for having me. This is good energy, man. I love you, DL. Hey,
you,
seriously, I love your whole crew, Slam crew, man. Thank you guys for having me. Seriously.
You're welcome.
Shout out to you guys.
You're welcome.
Before I forget, shout out to my power bag right here.
Again?
Yeah, check it out. Yeah. Thank you for waking me up.
That was your companion the whole show.
My
it took
us
a spot.
Yeah, yeah.
Plug into.
Milas Kajakibo. Hey, Fresca. Shout out to Fresca.
Yeah.
She's watching. She's
Supposed to be here.
She was supposed to be here. Yes.
It's all good.
Definitely. Shout out to my crew from the Filipino Kings of Comedy tour that we do. Alex Rototo, thank you so much for putting it all together. My parents, my fiance, if you're watching, love you, boo. And, God, thank you, God. Thank you for making this happen, God. This is great. This is beautiful, man. We all here, man.
For real.
Yes.
But, yeah. Yes, who else am I forgetting?
Did you do the martial art thing?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Do it again.
Definitely again.
This is
perfect. If you're a fan of, like, seriously, of kickboxing, we got Katrina the Storm Nahi. She's fighting May 5th at Cinco de Mayo in Oakland at the Marriott. You can get tickets at... akppromotions.org. But if you like girl fights, when girls get down nowadays, they
I love
go
girl
off.
Fights.
These
yes.
are like the future cyborgs. If you watch these girls,
mm-hmm.
they be killing it, man. So seriously, check it out, support.
And
yeah, and then I am Phil Am. I am
Phil M.
Yeah, let's talk about. You have like a clothing line or something.
Yeah, I don't
like
have a clothing line, but they're friends of mine. They're like, oh, you should do a shirt someday. You know, do something like of your you know your one of your jokes. So one of the jokes I say is, "Whose belongs this?"
Yeah,
yeah. So that was the thing. So you know,
we didn't get none of those.
I know. I need to bring it. I know. I wanted to bring some. I didn't have.
You know
any.
The rules.
If I brought some, you know,
you better leave that bag when you leave.
I'm about to come back. I'm about to hand deliver them.
He probably got two shirts in his bag, right?
I know. They didn't even see this tank top. Got a tank top for you, Stallion.
Thank you.
It's a baby tee. But I'll hook you guys up, though, seriously.
Sounds good. Can I borrow your tracksuit?
Yeah. But yeah, I and Philam, they do wonderful t-shirts. Not just mine, but they do a bunch of good stuff.
Right on. And yeah. Plug how they could watch you, keep in touch with you, come in contact.
Yes, your next show.
Yes, definitely.
Why do I have to fucking remind you about this?
Yeah. So I'll be around, man. I'll be around. No, watch a show, Mix Rated. It's our second season, Mix Rated. Shout out to my co-host, Keiko Lingus. My website is joeygila.com. Follow me on my Twitter, Joey Gila Live, and on Instagram, Facebook. I got a new Facebook now. It's Joey Gila 2. You like that?
Okay.
The first one's Phil, so it's 2. No, but I'll be in Vegas on the 5th and 6th hosting the Pinoy Pride Festival. This brother right here will be there. Yeah. Can you see him?
No, he can't.
That brother's single, too.
Oh, we're going to see him.
Show me Susu.
You said Pride, too. He jumped up real quick.
Yeah, the Pride. Yeah. And then I'm doing this Verizon tour where we're going to be in the Best Buy Theater in New York. And then we're doing, we're going to be Washington, D.C.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like I'm emceeing this kind of like this. I don't say if it's a K-pop tour, but there's this artist, Lil Craze. He's a rapper. He's dope.
Okay.
And Jay Park, he's one of the headliners. He's up, you know, he's like a star, like a Korean star. So we'll be going to San Francisco. We'll be going to L.A. and D.C. and New York.
Right on.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations. Oh, you want to add something?
Yeah, no? Sorry.
No, hey,
Scooter was hitting me up like, don't forget to plug Saturday. So with Fan TV, you know, with Dean, we're doing a performance and this little fundraiser thing.
Cool.
At Holy Angels this Saturday. Shout out to Dean. And if you guys are out in the D.C. area, definitely come through.
Hell's Angels? That's going to be kind of scary.
All right. Excellent, guys. I want to go ahead and close it out on this segment. I want to thank my entire crew for always doing their magic. My guest co-host, special co-host in the house, DL and Built to Grind. Thank you very much for making it.
Woo.
And the behind-the-scenes acts, Orville and Junior.
Oh. Orville and Redenbacher.
Orville and you guys Junior.
Below
Paps. Below Paps.
Below Paps.
Our special guest
friends
in the house, Paps. Joey Gila. Thank you very much.
Woo.
We haven't heard him do his Manny Pacquiao impression yet.
Manny Pacquiao.
I think the blow pops.
I think that's all over YouTube stuff. I'd like to say thank you to all the sponsors and affiliates out there. Without you, there is no us. I want to thank everyone that's in the chat room, corresponding, saying all the good, positive vibes. Without all this, we can't really make anything happen. We
yes.
need you to interact. And for all everyone that's just out there checking out the show, don't ever tune out. Stay put on a Monday night every single week. Thank you for that. Now, this is our free giveaway drawing.
I hope it didn't cost no money.
We're going to go ahead and give our guest, Joey Gila, the bowl, and he'll select the winning name. And that winner will get what, Sage?
Carlos Rice.
A Vix. I used one.
A Built to Grind backpack.
Ooh,
you
a
have backpack. It. You have it there.
A Built to Grind blop blop.
A drawstring bag.
Oh yeah,
down here. We just dropped on the floor. Looks like
okay.
a clock.
Okay, we're going to cut it with a scissor.
There you go.
There you go. So the winner will get this.
Here, I'll.
Good luck.
You want to read it?
Okay.
No, you can read it.
All
you
right. pull.
Okay, my friend. The winner is a Spanish name from El Salvador. The winner is Señor Hector Duenda.
Yeah.
Congratulations,
Hector. You got to contact us if you want your prize.
That's
there
right.
There you go. Is there anyone else, or is that the one prize?
That's one just per one week. Per week.
All right.
Unless you're giving out free backpacks.
Yeah.
Stallion's going to be on your ass.
Yeah.
Advice.
Big time. Advice. Excellent, guys. Excellent. Just reach out to us on TVEPN on Facebook, and we'll get you your prize, Hector. All right, that closes out the show, and we got a special dance number by Joey Gila
and the Blow Caps.
Yeah. Everyone out there, you guys take care. God bless.
It's over.
I love you.
Right on, right on.